Liposarcoma is a type of a sarcoma, which is a cancer of the cells that hold the body together, connective tissue cancer, but it's where the fat cells go crazy. There are problems in different kinds of liposarcomas, DNA, that turn them into cancer, and cells that should turn into nice benign globules of fat turn into angry, aggressive cancer cells that have the potential to spread, muck up the normal functioning of the body, and that is what cancer is. Virtually every patient I've ever seen with liposarcoma just comes in with a lump somewhere that's usually painless. A lot of people who have liposarcomas in the abdomen, which is one of the more common places, or the back of the abdomen called the retroperitoneum, feel like they might just be putting on some weight or getting a beer belly or something like that. And it's actually a little disconcerting when at some point somebody does a CT scan and the fat is not symmetric, and a doctor eventually does a biopsy, and that is the only way to diagnose liposarcoma. It is a very challenging diagnosis and needs an expert pathologist who really knows a lot about sarcomas. There aren't that many big reference centers with pathologists who have a lot of experience. Here at Dana-Farber Brigham and Women's Cancer Center, we happen to have more than our fair share of that kind of expertise, but other major cancer centers across the world might have an expert who has happened to take an interest in sarcoma pathology. Liposarcomas come in several types. There's well-differentiated, which means it's closer to a normal cell, and that has a characteristic DNA abnormality, but in general, it's a slow-moving tumor. Patients can have a well-differentiated liposarcoma the size of a large watermelon, and once it's taken out, they can still go on to live for decades. So it's that slow-moving. Many well-differentiated liposarcomas, though, can turn into de-differentiated liposarcomas, which implies they're starting to get more abnormal, and in fact, they tend to behave more abnormally. Now, this is an important thing because de-differentiated liposarcomas, when a pathologist looks at them under the microscope, they could look like other things. So we've seen a lot of diagnostic errors, shall we say, with pathologists who have one of those, but our pathologist changes the diagnosis to that thing. Then there's another type called myxoid or round cell liposarcoma that in general is one of the better types because we understand the DNA abnormality and understand it's very sensitive to many kinds of chemotherapy. And in many ways, the most worrisome type is something called pleomorphic. Pleomorphic liposarcoma means that each cell looks different from the next, implying it's making a lot of mistakes when a cancer cell makes a copy and turns into two cancer cells. And the pleomorphic liposarcomas really have, in many ways, the worst clinical outcomes and the least benefit from many kinds of chemotherapies. The key element here, though, is that many pleomorphic liposarcomas could be dedifferentiated liposarcomas. That really takes an expert diagnosis or a DNA test to see what the difference is. The last 15 years have been an exciting time in oncology as we figure out the wiring diagram of cancer cells, we're figuring out the blueprint of the cancer cell from the DNA problems. And by doing that, we've identified many abnormalities in the DNA of the well-differentiated and de-differentiated liposarcomas that have led to the development of new drugs that are currently in clinical trials with some extremely promising results. These are inhibitors of certain types of enzymes and certain types of other proteins in the cells, very much like the famous targeted therapies like Gleevec or inhibitors of other enzymes. But the exciting thing is that these are drugs that are very rationally targeting what's wrong in the cancer cell and to a great extent leaving the rest of the body alone. So for the vast majority of patients with liposarcomas, the well-diff and de-diff, there are some exciting new research options for them. Secondarily, there are many drugs that are in clinical trials for all types of liposarcomas, some of which are already approved in countries like Canada and European countries that we are trying to get approved by the FDA here in the United States based on some very high-quality randomized prospective studies that we're just awaiting the final results of.